In the previous video, we learned that fatty acids are long chains of carbon with a carboxylic acid functional group on one end. We learned that these are typically even-numbered carbon chains, and really common chain lengths in biological systems are 16, 18, and 20 carbons long. We talked about how fatty acids can come as saturated, which means there's no double bonds, or unsaturated, which contain at least one double bond. And in biological systems, these double bonds are almost always in the cis conformation. So unsaturated fatty acids have the double bonds in the cis conformation. We talked about how to name these fatty acids. We said that in the name, we write the number of carbons. So 16 would mean that we have 16 carbons. We have a colon, and then we have the number of double bonds present. If there are no double bonds, it's 16-0. This means we have a 16-carbon fatty acid with no double bonds. So it would look like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 16 carbons, and on the last carbon, we have our carboxylic acid functional group. If there's double bonds present, we indicate that by putting one or two or any number in this position after the colon. This means there are double bonds present. And we can figure out where that double bond is present in one of two ways. In the chemical way of naming these, we would put cis for a cis double bond, and then we would put delta and the position of the double bond. So it would be delta, let's say, 9. This means the double bond is present on the 9th carbon from the carboxylic acid. So if we start with our carboxylic acid functional group, we have carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And we have the double bond present as a cis. So between carbon 9 and 10 is a cis double bond. This is now carbon 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So this is a 16-carbon fatty acid with one double bond present on the 9th carbon from the C-terminus, from the carboxylic acid functional group, and it's present as a cis. We can also name this using the biological nomenclature, where we start numbering from the omega terminus, which is the very last carbon. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this double bond is present on the 7th carbon from the omega terminus. So we can name this 16-1-N-7. This means we have 16 carbons with one double bond present on the 7th carbon from the omega end, and in biological systems, these are absolutely always cis. Okay, so let's think about how we can name fatty acids that have more than one double bond. We call these polyunsaturated fatty acids. Okay, unsaturated meaning that we have double bonds present, and poly meaning more than one. Okay, so let's consider this molecule. Okay, we can name this in one of two ways. We can name it using the chemical nomenclature, where we start numbering from the carboxylic acid functional group. Okay, so we have 16 carbons. So this is 16. We have two double bonds. They're both cis, so I'm going to put cis, cis, and then we have one present on the 7th carbon, one present on the 10th carbon. So delta 7, delta 10. This means we have a double bond starting on the 7th carbon, so between 7 and 8, between 10 and 11, and both are cis. We can also name this using our biological convention, where we start numbering from the omega terminus. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this first double bond is six on the sixth carbon from the omega terminus. So 16, 2, n minus 6. And that's actually it. So that's all the information that we need to name this according to the biological convention. Okay, because within biological systems, all double bonds are present as cis. So we know that both of these are cis. And also, when we have multiple double bonds, they always skip a carbon. So if we have one double bond present on the sixth carbon, then it goes between 6 and 7. Carbon 8 does not have a double bond, but carbon 9 does. So it's always going to be three carbons apart. So this one, we have a double bond on the sixth carbon and the ninth carbon. Okay, let's draw a fatty acid that is 18, 3, n minus 3. This means we have 18 carbons with three double bonds, and the first one is on the third carbon from the omega terminus. So carbon 1, 2, 3, I have a double bond. So now carbon 4 has a double bond, 5, 6 has a double bond, 7, double bond 8, 9 is a double bond, so now this is carbon 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and this is where our carboxylic acid is. So this is 18, 3, n minus 3. We have carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. Okay? We have a double bond present on carbon 3, carbon 6, and carbon 9. They're always separated by a single carbon that does not have a double bond. Let's see if we can name this using our chemical convention. We start from the carboxylic acid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. So we have double bonds present on the 9th carbon, the 12th carbon, and the 15th carbon. So we would name this 18-3. All of our double bonds are cis. So cis, cis, cis. We have delta 9, delta 12, delta 15.